lot tonight being made of Vienna and Austria's rich musical history. So many famous composers have lived or worked in Vienna. And they like bread and cheese. And these bubbles and circles are about to morph into a very large ball. Stadthalle, where over 10,000 very excited Eurovision fans are waiting for the show to begin. This arena, unbelievably, was finished in 1958, but must have been incredibly modern at the time because it looks great. I think you'll agree. That is Lydia Bajsh at the violin, Russian-born, internationally acclaimed. And a large round of applause there for that man. That is Udo Jürgens, who won the Eurovision in 66 and was the last person to bring it.
Is Lydia Bajsh.
The door is opening there to reveal the ORF Radio Symphony Orchestra. In this opening sequence, there are over 200 performers involved. And I think you'll recognize the next one you see. Truly rising like a phoenix tonight. There she is, the reigning queen of Eurovision. Come on, Cheetah. And the crowd go crazy. This is Conchita meets Mary Poppins. Conversations, they sing. That's Miriam, Alice, and Arabella. I've worked with Alice, so I'll be kind to her. The other two are really rubbish. The one in the middle is the funny one. There she goes! Conchita incoming. And who's joining us now? Why, it's the Vienna Boys Choir. Thank you.
Yo, this right here, when you walk up on the stage and they all just disappear, kiss me dear, make me feel like you love me.
That's Arabella. She's special. Sparkwire, they provide free musical education internationally. I should warn
Welcome
you, by the way, there are, of course, flashing images and strobe lights throughout the show tonight. This cavalcade of stars just gives you some idea of what we'll be watching tonight. Much to look forward to. Including a mini Conchita concert. There they are! Electro Velvet. Nice cheer from the crowd.
Armenia. Lithuania.
I must say, and you won't believe me, but the standard
Serbia.
Of songs is quite high tonight. Oh, there's Bojana from Serbia. She has proved a big favourite with the crowd here all week. Don't worry, there's usual drops as well. And lots of things that leave you going only at Eurovision. If you fancy a sing-along, the song lyrics for all the songs, be they in English or another language, are available on the red button. There's a novelty act this year, Australia. We'll talk about more about that later. I won't be able to explain it, but we can talk about it.
Austria!
Big cheer for the homeboys. The Mate Mix. It's actually a really nice song.
Greece! Montenegro!
Huge excitement
Germany.
In Vienna for this contest. It was last year in 1967. So you know, United Kingdom, it's possible.
Poland.
It could happen. And of course, the last time it was here, the UK won. That was when Sandy Shaw took the trophy home with no shoes.
Spain. Hungary. Georgia.
So, 27 songs tonight, followed by 40 countries giving
Russia.
Their votes. You heard me. 40.
Albania.
But a bright spark in the voting is Nigella Lawson
and
will be
Italy.
Giving the UK results to the world. And that'll be the final country tonight, Italy there. All 27 now making their way to the stage. The stage is said to form an eye, which is something to do with bridges or circles or music or magic or compassion or... Well, anyway, it's beautiful. And actually, it is beautiful. The stage is a kind of more human scale this year. Still a big arena. Good opening, I'd say. Most things you could want there. And some things you didn't, like an Austrian rapper.
What a fantastic opening to our show. Thank you to all the artists here on stage.
Even if you say so yourself, Miriam.
And thanks to Conchita, we have the pleasure to welcome them here in Vienna, the 27 contestants of the grand final of the Eurovision Song Contest 2015.
That's Elise.
Wow, what a crowd here in Vienna. It surely is. The world's biggest music show, or as Australians put it, breakfast TV. By the way, welcome our very special anniversary guest in the contest. Hello, Australia!
Good drinking game is have a shot every time they say, good morning, Australia. They do it a lot.
And all of tonight's artists will bring life to our motto, building bridges. Bridges between countries, cultures, music styles, and most importantly, between people.
I might write that down,
Arabella.
And that's
exactly what Eurovision fans did over the last couple of weeks on our social media platforms. They have been building bridges all over the world.
This is a rather lovely film. And I know it's silly. It's just a song contest. But when you see things like this, you do understand what Eurovision's doing. And it'll bring people together on this one night. The music you're listening to is What If. It was a Russian entry about 3 years ago. Big day for Ireland. And a big night for Australia. It does seem like the ethos of last year's winner, Conchita, has really influenced the competition. It's a very good-humoured competition this year.
And to make sure the world remains the great place that it is, we are hosting this song contest as a green event.
Millions of families and friends in 45 countries watching together for one big party like this very big family of 10,000 party people here in Vienna. Hallo Wien, schön, dass ihr da seid!
Last year, an estimated 200 million people watched this song contest. And tonight, we're being beamed live to China, I'm told.
And I've got some news for you. For the first time ever, and I'm not kidding, we are even live in China.
We knew that, Miriam. I just told you. Don't bore
us. I've been so excited about that news. I've been learning Chinese all night long to welcome our new audience.
Please don't. Yeah, I'm
We're
with you, Arabella.
So much fun right now. But being part of Eurovision is not only fun. Actually, it's hard work because
you have to decide
who's going to be the big winner tonight. So make a choice, have an opinion, and shout it out loud. In short, act like a woman and vote.
And this is where I speak English. As usual, voting won't start. I mean, over them speaking English. Sorry, but I have to. It won't start until after all 27 acts are performed tonight. Please do not vote before then, as your vote won't count and you may still be charged. However, if you want to make a note of the phone number, it's 090-15-2252 from a landline, or the short code from a mobile is 62252. When the lines do open, you just need to add the number of the country you wish to vote for. This year, you can also vote via the app made by the people at Eurovision. UK viewers cannot vote by text. For full terms and conditions and details of how to get the Eurovision app, visit the website at bbc.co.uk/Eurovision. Now, to explain a bit more, the results of the viewer vote tonight will be combined 50-50 with the results of the national jury votes. The juries across Europe watched and voted on last night's dress rehearsal.
I'm ready, let's go.
No, 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 not us, them.
Oh. Yes, that's
three,
right.
2, 1.
Let the Eurovision Song Contest begin!
And as I said, many of tonight's performances do contain flashing images and strobe effects, including this first one from Slovenia. They're called Marija, and it's the combination of their two names. They are married and have two children. Now, the little postcards this year, the idea is a parcel is delivered to them in their home country, i.e. Slovenia, and the parcel contains a clue. And the clue is they come to Austria and they take part in some traditional Austrian activity. Like, this is lovely. They're going to the Lipizzana breeding farm where the white stallions are bred for the Spanish riding school. Lovely. Sadly, after about three of these postcards, they sort of run out of traditional Austrian things to do. they become quite random. Trademark is the headphones they're wearing. Not sure what they're listening to, but hopefully it's not this. Here for you, song number one.
When you're down, down low, and there's no place you can go. When you're down, down low, you know that I'm here for you. You came into my
song number one for Slovenia. Now, song number two. The producers put together the running order, and given that no song performing in second place has ever won, I'm guessing they didn't think much of this. Feel sorry for France. The artist is Lisa Angèle, and the song is N'oubliez pas.
Recording in progress.
Don't forget.
We can have a little sadly conversation later on, Kirsty, about how you feel. Otherwise, if
again,
you think
she's got a lovely little quite thing to do. She's off to a traditional tea party at the Summer Palace of Emperor Franz Joseph I.
Because year 8 Wednesday is much easier.
Hopefully,
okay?
She'll do better than last year when France did, in fact, come last with Twin and Moustache. The staging of this quite quick, and there's some drummers.
Hola, Raya. Yeah, clear and loud. It is working. Gracias.
Song 2.
Well. Now, guys, I really need to apologize about the. E. You see? So S is the correct one for my brother. And hardworking in Spanish is trabajador. So my brother is hardworking. Mi hermano es trabajador. Because he's a man, brother, then trabajador has to be masculine. Yeah, exactly. Then you need to find for yo, what it could be the correct present form for this verb there, for yo. Then you need to find for tú. Cousin Luis, well done. Next one is What is your favorite singer at the moment? Just mention people. Justin Bieber? Justin Bieber, why not? Jess Glynn? Yeah, okay, so we can play Jess Glynn. One Direction? Yeah, okay, so One Direction. Anything else? Oh, Ellie.
Wave at the
moment. Love it. Lovely. Sounds fantastic. Really good. Awesome.
Bueno,
muy bien. So I just chose Luis example. Mis pasatiempos favoritos son saltar con los caballos. Y let's say, y escuchar Taylor Swift, for example, from one of you guys, y escuchar Taylor Swift.
And if you go to bbc.co.uk/Eurovision, you can find out how to download that app.
I might need to review the
little
bit. Here
is your next chance. Everybody say, hey,
well,
to Sweden.
Two couple of examples.
This is the bookie's favorite.
Mis pasatiempos favoritos, look at that. Son saltar con los caballos, jumping with the horses, y escuchar Taylor Swift, and listening to Taylor Swift.
I'd say it is one of the cleverest bits of staging.
Bueno,
that I've seen.
¿Qué haces en tu tiempo libre? What do you do in your free
time?
It could be similar like this.
But it is so clever and imaginative.
But you have different hobbies.
Truly effective.
Okay, what other hobbies do you have, guys? Apart from listening
guy,
music, reading. Vale, so let's choose that one. Baile, reading.
This might be
what do
winner.
You do? Entonces you can say.
Now, did you know?
En mi tiempo libre. En mi tiempo
here,
libre.
By the Austrian Space
me gusta
this could just
bailar.
Be calm, reading now, why not?
Leer.
Duckstein Ice Cave.
What else?
That ice is 500 years
old. Jugar rugby. I don't know. There are many possibilities. Jugar rugby. Dibujar, drawing. I like that. And dressed up. Cantar, yeah, singing. Anything else? I try to put as much as I can. Yeah, bailar, danzar, yeah, bailar. Dormir. Sleeping? Okay, why not? Dormir? What does rowing mean? Can you explain me a little bit more about that, Tyrek? Sorry about my ignorance. Rowing. Rowing? It's a sport, isn't it? It's a boat racing. Ah! Canotaje. Yes, canotaje. Yes, canotaje. I like that. I would. That's very adrenaline, isn't it? Canotaje, rowing. Bueno. I'm sure it is. Lots of adrenaline, isn't it? Bueno, so look at that one, guys.